After nearly 2 years of operating at a loss and racking up debt, nearly 2 years of doing the right thing for rural Alberta communities, Coldshot and their fellow operators need $3 million to stay in operation. $3 million for operating money, not to pay down debt. And I think that's a small price to pay compared to the impact on the communities if they were forced to pull their buses off the road. Now, British Columbia has already provided financial support to keep these lifelines intact. I asked the Minister of Transportation repeatedly about this in the House earlier this month, and she said Coldshot wasn't eligible for help because they are a for-profit private company. That's a bunch of baloney for two reasons. Number one, Coldshot has been running at a loss for nearly 2 years. They are effectively a nonprofit. If these guys were just in it for the money, they wouldn't still be driving these buses with half the seats empty. But they have been, because they are there for Albertans who are on the bus. This is their only option. That's a service to these communities and a service to our province, and it should be recognized. Secondly, when has the UCP ever been shy about giving money to a for-profit company? Last I checked, TC Energy is an extremely profitable company, but that didn't stop Jason Kenney from gambling $1.3 billion of Albertans' money on a Keystone XL. The UCP's entire economic plan is built around handing over $4.7 billion in giveaways to profitable corporations. But here we have a small Alberta-owned company that was doing its part to help rural Alberta through the pandemic, and the doors slammed in their face. It's not right. I'll be asking the minister about this again today. I hope she comes to her senses and sees that keeping rural bus service operating is a sound investment.
According to the Alberta government, we are a for-profit enterprise, which justify them in turning down repeated requests for assistance. But for those 16 months, we were not turning any profit, losing money every day. Regardless, we don't expect taxpayer money to compensate that 100%. We do have ridership, which can compensate some of it. We are not expecting any checks in the mail for $6 million. We are asking for the province to help us out with the break-even point, subsidize the running cost only. Currently, we are out only running 6 routes in Alberta out of 11. Now struggling to maintain our buses and service routes. All we are asking is to help us and support us for the running cost.